Hello everybody, welcome to English Grammar Models. In this slide, first we'll start with auxiliary verb. What is an auxiliary verb? It is also called as an helping verb and it is used with a main verb to help express the main verb's tense, mood or voice. Auxiliary verbs, they are divided into two types, primary auxiliary and modals. Primary auxiliary verbs, they are generally used as a main verb in a class and it is used to conjugate to reflect plurality and tense as a result. Primary auxiliary verbs, they are divided into three types. The first one is be verbs, example for which are am, is, was, are and were. The second one is do verbs, example for which are does, do and did. The third one is have verbs, example for which are has, have and had. The next one is modals. Modals denote the mood of the sentence. They denote the type of expression of the sentence. Examples for modals are can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, must. There are semi-modals, which are also known as quasi-modals. Example for which are need, dare, used to and ought to. Here you see a tabular column mainly depicting modal verbs, expressing modal verbs. Examples: ability, can, could. I can swim. When I was young, I could run fast. Permission, can, could, may. Can I use your phone, please? Excuse me, could I just say something? May I come in? Advice, should or ought to. You should or ought to revise your lessons. Obligation, must. You must stop when the traffic lights turn red. Possibility, may, might, can, could. Where are my keys? They may be in the car. I might go on holiday to Australia next year. Smoking can cause cancer. It could rain tomorrow. Prohibition, must not. You must not smoke in the hospital. Lack of necessity or absence of obligation. Need not. I need not buy tomatoes. There are plenty of tomatoes in the fridge. Uses of auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary verbs are used in or to indicate tenses. They are used to frame questions in the case of short answers, in question tags, in active and passive voice, in direct and indirect speech, and they are also used in negatives. Do's and don'ts. Necessity, obligation and permission. Choose the correct option. First one, we use dash. The choices are should, must, ought to. When something is compulsory, obligatory and important. The correct answer is we use must when something is compulsory, obligatory and important. The second one, we use dash. The choices are should, must, ought to when something is the right thing to do. The correct answer is we should use should when something is the right thing to do. Third one, we use dash. The choices are should, must, ought to when something is suggested or recommended. The correct answer is we use ought to when something is suggested or recommended. Thank you, students.